you look at these images, it's devastating.
What's been the most stunning and shocking image that you've seen that we've covered today?
You know, I think one of the things that's sticking with me is a chopper video of the house that the water is up to its roof level. Mm-hmm. You just hope that those people got out because, again, you know, if I was in that area and I knew 15 inches of rain was coming, I don't know if I would have left. Mm-hmm. You know, right. So you just got to think, hopefully in the middle of the night, water started coming out and they're able to get out before that really got up to the level it got to. Uh-huh. You know, I mean, I forgot who was the reporter who was saying someone had to use a chainsaw to get it, clear their way out. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that rain is just devastating. It just has nowhere to go.
I want to go back to Volusia for one more question, though. Mm-hmm. I guess what I don't understand is how can a hurricane that makes landfall near Fort Myers and travel all the way across the state, mm-hmm. When it gets to Central Florida, inflicts damage at its final stop? Well, the most damage at the final stop.
Right. I mean, it's just because it was going fairly slow, about 78 miles per hour. It just had so much rain to dump. And while it hit Fort Myers as a Category 4, almost even Category 5, that's a lot of momentum of winds and spin. So it has to wind itself down. So it still had plenty of strength and power as it was working its way across the peninsula. But then you get onto the other side, and it starts wrapping all that Atlantic moisture back onto shore. So you get the storm surge issues as well up there. And then as the storm surge pushes up along the coast, most of the rivers and most of the drainage systems drain out towards the ocean. Well, if the ocean is piling up against those pipes, it just can't drain out.
So you got slapped going one way and turned around and slapped it going the other.
Yep.
Incredible.
Wow.
All right, Alex, thank you.